5 years. Today I am going to tell about one interesting case. Here there is a woman who is having a lot of problems in the uterus, and more than 15 years she was suffering from primary infertility, and then she had a multiple surgeries, multiple IVF failures in most of the IVF centers, and then followed by, because she landed up with complications, she was having severe uterine pain, for which she has approached to one of the doctors locally who referred to us. And when she came, we were really worried about her pain and then uterine status, and we were trying to counsel her, we will do a surgery and release all the factors, correct the factors, then you can go through the pregnancy. But the amount of sufferings and pain she has gone through it, and negative results of so many IVF treatments, she was very much fed up, and she said, I don't want anything pregnancy, first let me remove this uterus and relieve of pain. So that was our first priority. So we counseled her and then taken through her through laparoscopy. During the laparoscopy, we found out that there was a lot of blood collection and damage to the uterine walls, and there is no point in repairing or retaining the uterus. So after that, after counseling, proper consent, we proceeded with hysterectomy. After removal of her uterus, she had only option of surrogacy. So in that surrogate, we counsel whole family to get someone who is known to her, a relative. So this patient, Mrs. Bharati, she has brought her own relative and was willing for all these procedures, and then staying here for almost 9 months, and then carry through the pregnancy. After proper counseling, documentation in front of the lawyer, and everything was explained to the couples and also to the surrogate mother and their family, and then we have done the IVF. First cycle ICSI itself, she had a twin pregnancy, and 3 months, till 3 months they were kept in the hospital and monitored closely. After 3 months, she was kept near our hospital only, in our guest house, so that her pregnancy was followed like any other pregnancy, like other normal pregnancy. If the recipient mother carries the pregnancy, how we will be doing the same thing we have done in the surrogate mother. And recipient mother also, she was also staying with the surrogate and taking care of her throughout her pregnancy. This is what we have seen, that bonding between the both surrogate and recipient, because they are known to each other and relatives, and then there was no disparity or anything, and the care was excellent. And in the hospital also, we have taken care of her very well. And throughout the pregnancy, all the regular checkups, the test, everything has been done. Scans were serially done, monitored. And nearing 9 months, she had a small non-reactive NST. And then we have to do emergency cesarean. And we delivered 2 babies, more than 2 kgs. Both babies are fine. They were only kept in NICU just for feeding the babies. Because of surrogacy, they cannot feed. So we have to give them and feed everything in the NICU and make sure their sugar levels are all right. After that, within 2 or 3 days, babies are shifted back to our mother's side, and a recipient is taking care of her genetic parents are taking care of the babies. They are very happy with the babies. So why, what I am here, I am trying to say is, once we go through the proper guidelines and follow the guidelines, and if you let them know, both recipient and the surrogate mother, each other, and if they discuss everything before the procedure, there won't be any hassle. And even many surrogate mothers in GBR Fertility Centre, they are going through, and we are not seeing any difference between surrogate mothers and the other normal pregnancies, because everybody comes regularly, does their thing, and there is nothing like something special we are doing there in there. Because there is no middleman involved here, and then the understanding and the documentation is clear. So at the time of delivery also, handing over the baby becomes very simple and easy, so that there won't be any tension. Most of the time in the surrogacy, because of the fear, psychosis, lot of media reports and lot of other patients' reports, other hospital reports, patients come up with a lot of presumptions, saying that this may happen like this, this may happen like that. None of the things will happen if we follow properly and have a counseling before starting the procedure. And in our team, in IVF, we properly give them a counseling, tell all the complications, what worse can happen, how we can manage even in those situations, so that everybody is prepared and everything is explained in their own languages. Then when they go through it, I am not seeing any other difference or any complications in the surrogate mother. So I just try to tell you this because for many of them are trying to go for surrogacy for so many other reasons, but the indication is correct, and if the both the parties are okay and understanding, it will be a smooth journey to have a healthy, happy motherhood. Thank you.